Okay, we're continuing on the subject of floating divs so that we can do page layout. And what we're going to look at right now is just a quick look at document flow so that you have a little bit of understanding of how that compares to the divs once we start floating them. So I have a series of four files open here, different layouts that we want to take a quick look at and see what we have. The first one I have here, I've named one column header footer. So it's just a basic layout. If we look at it right here, we have a header at the top. I've given it a green background so you can tell where it is. Then it has one column sitting in the middle, which is a div content if I highlight that down here. And if I scroll down, I see that I have a footer at the bottom. This one's very straightforward and would actually work as we suspect it does. I can go look at code and we could look at it there, but there's also an option that we can look in Dreamweaver. I can go up to the View menu and go to Style Rendering, and here where it says Display Styles, I can turn that off. So basically, it's turning off all of the CSS or the cascading style sheets for this file. Even though they're still there, they've turned them off for the moment. And so we can see if we look at the top, I have a header up here. So you have a div header. I can select it. You can see the blue outline on it. It, of course, is sitting within our div container. That's our page, or what we think of as our page right there. So the header at the top, directly below that, starting with the H1 that says instructions, we see that that's sitting in a div content. And then directly below that, we have a div footer. So in this case, we have three divs stacked in a row. And when we go view those, I'll go turn display styles back on, then they've been styled. In other words, we have, like on our container, we have a width. We notice that it's been centered. You can see out here where the margins are set on auto to center it. We have different sizes, different colors applied. But the document flow and then how it displays with the CSS is still, it's still in the same order. So we have header, content, and footer. So this is our first and simplest layout. The other ones we're going to look at, let's move on to our second one right here. This one I've labeled two column left sidebar. So this is the standard one that I use an awful lot of the time in class, just to sketch a very quick layout. We have the header at the top, again having a green background so we can see where it is. At the bottom, we have a footer, so that sits right there. And then we have these two side-by-side columns. I have a sidebar on the left. I've labeled it there so we can notice that, where that sits in the code, if we go look at code. And then we have the main content area, which is a class of content right here. So this is very standard. In this case, though, we want to look at the document flow. How are the divs lined up in the document flow? Because then we have to take them and push them to the different sides or float them. So again, if I go up to View, I go down to Style Rendering, and I turn off Display Styles to get rid of the styling, the CSS. We notice that the header div is still at the top, which makes sense. Anytime that we add a div, by default, it's full width of the container. So it just sits there. That's great. Immediately after that, we have the div that has sidebar, or is the sidebar div. Following that, we have the div for content. And following that, we have the div for footer, all of which are sitting within the container div. So we see that our order is header, sidebar, content, and then footer. So when we start looking at floats in the next video, we'll see how it is that we take the sidebar div right here. So as the browser's running through the code, it hits header, it leaves it up at the top full width. It hits sidebar and it has to know to make it narrow and float it to the left. Then it comes across content. It has to make it narrow as well. It's going to float to the left and follow it. So it'll be to the right of the other one, but it's following sidebar. And then footer directly below that. So we get to see how those reside in the code here. Let's go back up here and turn my style rendering back on again. Going to my third file, you notice this one is almost the same as the previous. I have a header, I have two columns, and I have a footer at the bottom. But now my sidebar is sitting on the right of my content div. Okay? So you might suspect that the document flow has reversed, which Without looking at it, you might suspect that it's header, followed by content, followed by sidebar, and then footer. However, if we go up and again we turn off the styles, you'll notice that it is header, followed by sidebar, followed by content, followed by footer. So this file is actually identical to this file. I'm flipping between them and you notice that there's no difference on the screen. These two files are identical in content, so it's all styling that has changed at this point. So as the browser runs through the code, it comes across the header, it leaves it full width, runs all the way across within its container. When it comes to the sidebar div, we have CSS that tells it to make it narrow, but in this case it tells it to float right, so it pushes it off to the right side of the screen. It then comes to content, it makes it narrow, it floats to the right following the sidebar, so it sits on its left because it's following sidebar. And then it comes across footer. Footer again is left full width, and so it just sits across the bottom of the screen. Okay, one more time. Let's turn our styling back on and go to my final file. Now, in this case, I have two sidebars. So I have the header at the top, as always. I have a sidebar one on the left. I have a content area in the center. I have a sidebar two on the right. And then, as always, I have my footer sitting across the bottom. So the question is, how is this one built? And I just wanted to show you this one to show that we do have actually a lot of control as far as where we want to push the different items. So again, I'm going to go up to view, go turn off my style sheets. I've got my header at the top. It's followed by sidebar one. And then it's followed by sidebar two. Then we get the content area. Then we get the footer. So you notice that we have the sidebars following each other. So as the browser moves through this code, it hits the header. It's told just to leave it full width, so it stays where it is. It comes across the code for sidebar one. And in this case, the CSS tells it to make it narrow and float it to the left, so it sits off on your left. Then it comes across the code for sidebar two, and the CSS tells it to make it narrow and float it to the right. So now at this point I have a narrow one on the left, then I have a narrow one on the far right. Then as it reaches the code for content, the CSS tells it to make it narrow, and then it can tell it to float left or to float right. It honestly doesn't really matter at this point, but as long as you put a float on it, it's going to slide up between the other two because it's following them. And then finally you have the footer, which is set to be full width, and so it sits all the way across the bottom. I'm going to go turn my styles back on again, and here's where we can see again we have header, we've got sidebar 1, so it tells it to make it narrow, float left. Then remember sidebar 2 was next in code, it tells it to make it narrow and float to the right. And then finally it comes across the content area, and it tells it to make it narrow, and as long as you put a float on it, then it'll slide it between the other two. Then we have the footer down here, and we've left it to be full width. So that is just a quick summary of document flow so that you can see how the code sits in HTML and then how we can control it through CSS. And of course, this is in the theory, at the theory level. We're going to actually go in Dreamweaver and look at how we use this code. What I want to point out is how the columns have been taken out of the document flow using float. So as we reach that code in HTML, we use CSS to float them. They move out of the document flow and shift one side or the other. And I guess I should point out that, of course, document flow is how search engines see the code, or screen readers, because that's the order the code is in. So that is everything on document flow. After this, we're going to move on to actually the application of floats.